be honest, you have no idea, do you?
It's the decision that will be taken at the earliest possible moment. Schools were the last to close. Schools will be the first to return.
But as we sit here, you have no idea, do you?
We're in a position where when we have the best scientific advice, when we have the best health advice, that, you know, this was a national decision.
I understand all that. I'm just saying that obviously you assured us in late December that the schools would definitely be reopening. Everyone got wildly excited and everyone went back to school for one day and then they had to shut, which was one of many, many U-turns that you've had to make in this pandemic. I mean, if you go over your charge sheet, your record as leading our education system, repeatedly shamed over school meals by a footballer, exam result fiasco, the school reopening catastrophe, where you basically sent millions of kids back to school for one day to all infect each other and then go back to their homes so they could infect their elderly relatives, which may now be why we have this horrifying daily death number. We had a poll at ITV 2 weeks ago. We asked England's teachers whether you should resign. 92% of them said you should go. And it does beg the question, given this series of abject failures that you've presided over in the last 10 months, why are you still Education Secretary? Why haven't you done the right thing and resigned and let somebody more competent take over and do a proper job? Because you have failed our kids.
So, Piers, we're facing more disruption to our education system than we've ever seen, even during the Second World War. We are faced with a new variant of the virus that at the start of December wasn't known about, and even in mid-December.
We knew about the new variant on the 19th of December, because the Prime Minister told us it was 70% more transmissible. And yet you said a week later the schools were going to reopen, even though many experts were saying, don't be ridiculous, that is a crazy thing to do. You then insisted on reopening for one day and said there was not going to be a U-turn. And literally after one day, you shut them down. It is hard to conjure up a more incompetent decision-making process than that.
Well, the best the advice that we're receiving as to whether we could continue to have primary schools open, we'd already delayed the opening of secondary schools in light of the new variant. But then when the country moved into a COVID alert level 5 and more of the data was coming through, it was a national decision that was taken in the national interest to close schools. Obviously something that we didn't want to see.
Your it was the thing that in the second... Can I ask you? It's a straight question. Have you offered your resignation to the Prime Minister at any stage of this pandemic, yes or no?
My focus is making sure that children get the best remote education while they're not in school.
Of course it is. You're the education secretary. I expect it to be. But have you offered your resignation?
Our focus is making sure that children
get the best remote
moment. And, Piers, the other thing that we're doing...
Is there a problem on the line? Can you not hear me?
Mr.
Williamson, you seem to be totally ignoring me. I'm just asking you a straight question. Given the level of failure in your reign as Education Secretary in this pandemic, given that 92% of teachers in England want you to go, given that you're being described by the Labour Party and the Liberal Democrats as the worst Education Secretary in British history, I simply ask you, have you looked in the mirror and thought, you know what, I've done a terrible job, I'm going to say to the Prime Minister, it's time for me to step aside and let somebody more competent take over. Have you had that conversation with yourself, and have you then had it with the Prime Minister?
Piers, my one focus is making sure we deliver
the
very best.
We know what your focus is. You're the Education Secretary. The problem is your focus has not proven to be very good, has it?
We're dealing with a global pandemic where we've had to make decisions at incredible pace, decisions that none of us would have wanted to
make. You've made a series of bad decisions, Education Secretary, decisions that have had huge ramifications for teachers, for students, for parents. You've been a catastrophe. Own it.
So our focus is always about bringing children back into the classroom at the earliest possible moment when the advice is that we can do so. We're going to be giving children, we're going to be giving teachers, schools and parents as much notice as
possible. Why should any of them believe a word you say, given the speed that we go into U-turns after everything that comes out of your mouth? Seriously.
Mr. Williamson, I'll give you an example, and that is that And many parents expected their children to go back to school after February half term. How close to that point do you think we can imagine we can do that?
Well, we want to see it at the earliest possible moment, but that's going to have to be a decision that's looking closely at the health data, NHS capacity. And while we want to give people as much notice of that, and that would be sort of 2 weeks' notice in terms of actually whether schools are returning
it's
or not.
It's not going to happen after February half-term, is it? Sorry, just as an informational exercise for parents and teachers who are trying to plan their lives, it's not going to happen anywhere near February half-term, is it?
So what we'll be doing is we'll be guided by best scientific advice and,
I'd rather you were just honest with us. You haven't got a clue when they're going to reopen. Last time you reopened, you did it for 24 hours. You don't have a clue, do you?
We will be guided by best scientific and health advice. We'll obviously make that decision as close to the point as possible, making sure teachers, schools, staff, pupils all have 2 weeks sort of notice.
Why does the UK currently have the worst death rate for coronavirus in the entire world?
Well, what we've seen is one of, with a new variant that we saw emerge, this has had, the trajectory that we were going on in terms of the direction that this country was travelling on has been sort of massively disrupted as a result of that new variant. So, I didn't believe, as most people didn't, in terms of a generally improving outlook and the fact that we're having the extensive vaccine rollout, that we would be in the place that we are here.
Why did you cancel Christmas, Mr. Williamson? Why did you allow millions of people to meet and mix on Christmas Day when you knew in the weeks and days before, at least a week before Christmas, that there was a new, highly transmissible variant? You allowed millions of people to meet up with each other.
So, as you'll recall, when there was the announcement of the new variant, the government took immediate action to move a large part of the country, over 75% of England, into a new tier, which was tier four, because we recognised that actually action needed to be taken in order to be able
and
to deal with this new variant.
The rest of the country allowed to mix on Christmas Day.
And in those other areas, the evidence and the data was showing that the case rates in those areas...
The truth is, Mr. Williamson, that once again, the government locked us down too late and we're now reaping the whirlwind in deaths from that dithering and delay. Exactly the same as we saw back in March. That's why we're seeing 1,800 deaths recorded in the last 24 hours yesterday, 1,600 the day before. It's 3 to 4 weeks after Christmas. That decision was a disaster. And we all know, let's leave with one question. Because you avoided this earlier. And by the way, I know that your focus is on education. I'd expect it to be because you're education secretary. What would it take for you to resign?
My job is to deliver the very best for every child in this country. That's what I'm focused on. Today we're launching a Skills for Jobs programme. This is about, yourself included, college. We're very much focused on actually making
sure... Are you skilled
at
your job? Given you're launching a Skills for Jobs programme, are you skilled at your job?
My focus is in delivering for all youngsters right across the country, making sure we have a skills agenda,
avoiding any difficult questions that I want to ask you. So we'll leave it there. Thank you very much indeed.
Thanks, Peter.
All from us now. Thank you. All from us now. Here's Lorraine.
Thank you both very much. After the break.